Back inside the CBS Arena, just outside of St. John's, Newfoundland and Labrador, we're getting set for our second girls U19 semifinal. Winner of this gets the Newfoundland and Labrador selection, the national championship, tomorrow afternoon. We have got the Manitoba North Stars to take on Team BC. Just waiting for the start of the national anthem, and we'll get underway with this girls semifinal. Well, they've got it on the iPad or the tablet. Here we go. All right, this game between BC and Manitoba, these two teams did meet in the preliminaries. Manitoba North Stars came out victorious 5-4. Obviously very close game, not much difference between these two teams. North Stars to your left, green and gold. BC to your right with the white, blue. Starting goaltenders in goal for BC, number one, Bella Graywall. For Manitoba, number 30, Maggie Glass. Zone two of the boards. BC on it, taken away and behind the goal though. Justine Tremblay. Tremblay threw it out in front, it comes back to the point, chipped away. Played down a little bit further by Maggie Matani. Hannah Kostinen for BC. Matani looking around. Matani swinging out to the front. Can't get a shot away, comes back to the point. Emma Powell. It's it back down low. Vikowitz. Player knocked down and right away we're going to get a penalty coming up. Still waiting for him to touch it. Minute and 1 second into the game, we get our first penalty. It's been a kind of penalty-filled evening. Two minutes roughing going against British Columbia. Brooke Tuba onto the penalty box. Power play, Manitoba. That's cleared down the floor right away. Winning the faceoff will kill a lot of time. That shot in, Manitoba will go into forecheck. battling along the boards. Finally, Manitoba come up with it, able to hold it in. Carnegie. Carnegie headed over to Alicia Powell, back to Carnegie, shot on goal. It's tipped and goes wide. Graywall made the save on the first one. The rebound was here. Graywall kicks that to the boards. 47 seconds to go in the power play. Taken by Nekwajuk. They'll get another penalty. This one against, we didn't get it put up on our graphics. That's okay, because now it's going to be 4-on-4. No, they're going to go both of them. So we can't put it up. Both players going for roughing, one each team, so they will cancel each other, and still just the 40 seconds left in the penalty to Team BC. BC win the faceoff, they'll get it and shoot it down the floor. Matani taken away by D. Janelle D doing good work, killing some time on this penalty to BC. Finally, Manitoba come out with it. Fast gets it in over the blue line. 15 seconds left to go in the power play. A shot in, and Graywall's got it. She wasn't quite sure, but it's between the pads. Just a note for you, there's a game scheduled at the Robert French Arena, the U17 boys, Withrow Park versus Newfoundland Labrador selects. Because of the extreme heat over at the Robert French Arena, it's very warm and humid here in around St. John's the last few days, and they've decided, because of the heat that's been building there all day, that game is going to be moved here to the CBS Arena right after this girls semifinal. That didn't go in. A big pileup is in now. They call it a goal. Referee indicates it's good. What a mass of humanity in front of the goaltender. You didn't see anything here. It's backhanded down in the corner and then played out in front. One shot at it by Prochick. Referee was right there, saw the ball was loose the whole time. Never covered. So it's 1-0 for Manitoba. It'll go down as a power play goal. Ginger Fast. Prozic gets the assist. So Roviak with a shot for BC, comes back at the point, sent back in, that'll go wide of the goal. Valiquette trying to hold it in at the blue line. Olema comes in to help out. Finally, Manitoba move it out. No further than the center red line. Dumped back in by Bolema. BC will change. Back to get it. Fitzpatrick to DiStasio. Tuba. Delacqua. Costin able to keep it in for BC. To the front of the goal it comes. The ball was bouncing. Going to be a penalty coming up to Manitoba. The BC player was knocked down in front of the goal. Emma Powell down to the penalty box. Power play now for BC. Manitoba converted their power play opportunity. So if you have somebody on that, what was U17? Withrow Park, where Newfoundland and Labrador selects. It's going to be moved to here to CBS Arena. It'll be a late night. We will cover that one for you. Pagosa can't get a shot through. Ball bounces free. BC is on it. Long shot towards the goal. It changed direction and went just wide. Cho with a chance. A couple of big saves made by Glass. I think the first one may have hit her in the face mask. She's got it again. This time doesn't give up a rebound. Maggie Glass holding the fort down for Manitoba. Both teams wholesale changes. Still a minute one left to go in the power play for BC. Faceoff won by Manitoba. Rung around the boards by Brown. Itani looking for it, getting to it first was Lee. Out in front, it rattles around and down the floor. Shot from a sharp angle, misses and comes around the boards. That hit the outside of the net. Back to Tuba, her shot. Glass got a piece of that. And the power play is now over. BC had their chances. Maggie Glass was brilliant. Another penalty. Body checking. Go against Manitoba. Maggie Mitani down to the penalty box. Shot in by Colhart. Cho with a chance and diving out, blocking it was Alicia Powell. That was an empty net. Defenseman got a stick on it and deflected it up high. Glass without the stick, catches it and holds on. That was amazing. Cho had an empty net. She's looking up at the ceiling now, can't believe it. Some water spilled just outside. Team BC players mentioned need to get that wiped up. Minute 27 to go in the power play as they continue to try and wipe off the water. Quite a bit spilled over there. Got some towels out. Somebody dropped a water bottle, I think, and got a few towels going there now. Okay, let's get a bigger towel out. Unfortunately, oh, that's a shirt they're using there now. Okay, camera guy's zoned out. He's had enough tonight. Cleanup completed. Shot over the top of the goal. Cho behind the goal, still on the power play is BC. They walk it in. Glass has got that in the glove. Well, how good is Maggie Glassman in this game? Sent down the floor by Manitoba. Michaela Kush plays it into the corner, picked up by her teammate, and they'll bring it up the floor. They'll go back to Kush from Calhart. Pagosa chips it in. In there first, Fitzpatrick. Over to Dickiewicz and down the floor. Penalty is now over. Tip down the floor. First down there will be Haley Drew. Actually, it's Matani, just came out of the penalty box. 21, not 11. Matani turning, knocked off her stick. That was blocked up high and goes out of play. Faceoff stolen by BC. Get the center. Good pass up at the blue line. Huey turn down into the corner, looking for Janelle D. D works up along the board, cycles it back down low. Players go to the boards. D comes up with it. D gets it to the front of the goal, cleared away by Alicia Powell. We go to the other side, down the floor. Powell pushes it ahead, that's still onside. Gets it to D'Stasio, down into the corner. Drew battling down there against Valaket. And finally the whistle goes. Thank you. PC, bring it out. In over the blue line, Molly Cho. Manitoba throw it around the boards. Lizotte. It'll be kept in. Soroviak for Pogor. Back to Soroviak. Down into the corner. Cho will get there first. Cho. Right out in front. That hit the goal post. Came back in front. Glasses got it. Great chance for BC. Right off the goal post. There you go. I was about to say Maggie Glass has made a mistake. She didn't thank the goalpost, but as I was about to say that, she reached back and gave it a little tap. Thanks so much, my friend. All goalies know when you hit the post, you got to thank your goalpost, and there's another chance. If she hadn't thanked it, that would have gone in. Zahn right out in front, and Glass makes the save. So Glass with another one. First one off the post, then comes up with the big save. BC pressing, down 1-0. 3:11 here in the first period. They win another faceoff. That goes over the top of the goal. Picked up back there. It's Lee. Threw it in front, it's cleared to the boards. Dickowitz. Dickowitz down the floor. It'll go down in deep. Calhart. Reverses it. Lee coming in to get it. Lee to Pagosa. Taken by Calhart. Calhart in over the blue line. Pagosa. That shot over the top. Rebound is there. They score. Too many chances for BC. They've been all over Manitoba the last 3 or 4 minutes. And I think it was Zahn. This is Pagosa. Her shot goes over the top of the goal, but it comes out in front. Is that one of those ones that goaltenders have to be oh so careful of those balls that come off the end boards. Zahn is here, taps it home, 1-1. Game with about 2.5 minutes left to go in the first period. Tremblay trying to split the defense. Just cleared off her stick at the last second. That was Powell, another great defensive play. Bolema along the boards. Bolema comes away with it. Bolema went off the referee. Bolema's got it. Bolema walking out in front. Tremblay, who started all this with that rush. To the side of the goal, comes Tremblay, scores! Justine Tremblay, fittingly, ends up with the goal. Okay, this is the previous one. We will come out of that. But it is 2-1. So So a couple of late goals here in this opening period of BC out in front, 2-1. Into the final minute. Polgor for BC. It's been all BC in the last 6-7 minutes. Lee looking for it. Lazat, it's not going to get out. Lee coming off the boards. For Pagosa, just a little bit too far for her. She'll track it down in the corner. Pagosa in behind the goal. Polgor playing it back to the point. Don't know if there's going to be time for Manitoba off the foot. No, it won't be, as it'll go to the boards and time will run out. Manitoba struck first, but two goals late by BC have them out in front. And we'll be back with period number two of this under 19 girls semifinal in just a few minutes. Shot goes off the glass to the boards, picked up by Matani. Matani of Manitoba makes a good move to get free, brings it in over the blue line. Her team trails 2-1. Matani with a good rush. Good save by Graywall. Zahn at center. Couldn't beat Carnegie. And 53 seconds in, we'll get a flooring call. Again, a reminder, this was scheduled to be our last game of the day. This was scheduled to start at 8:20. It's running late, and in addition, we've added another game to our schedule. The boys under 17, Withrow Park, Newfoundland Labrador Selects game has been moved from the Robert French Arena to here because of the heat and humidity inside the Robert French. And it's been an issue the last couple of days. It's been really warm in there. Also at the Ghouls, not so bad here at CBS, much bigger arena. A little more room for air to circulate. Actually, it hasn't been bad at all, given the heat and humidity outside. Rained heavily earlier today, and then the sun came out again. But as I mentioned yesterday, much of Newfoundland Labrador, like many other parts of the world, been under a heat wave the last couple of weeks. Humidex in central Newfoundland for nearly a full week consecutive, up in the mid-40s. Unheard of. We get days in the 30s. We might get the occasional day with the humidex in the high 30s, but for a full week or more of humidex in the 40s, it's off the chart. And hot air, not quite as hot on the Avalon, but much hotter than normal. The Avalon Peninsula of Newfoundland and Labrador, the easternmost part of the island, where St. John's is. That came off the end boards right out in front. Another chance for BC. That shot hit some bodies in front. Cho plays it behind the goal. Reaching forward is Fast. Fast can't get it out, stopped by Cho. BC looking very good here in the third period, as they were towards the end of the second, picking up where they left off. Calhart throws it in. They won't get it out. Great job by Esther Bolema. This one will get out and down the floor. Delacqua just got rid of it. They need to get off and get some fresh legs on there. Kept in by Kostinen, and then it goes out of play. Going to bring the faceoff outside the blue line. Back to pick it up, Kostinen. Good pass. Finds Summer Yui. Taken away by Posick. And a penalty has been called. It will go against BC. Two officials get together. 2-minute penalty. Summer Yui. Trailing by one, Manitoba go on the power play. Calhart turns, sends it down the floor. Shot right on goal, kicked away by Graywall. And again, sent down the floor. One and done on that power play attempt. Manitoba keep it in. 45 seconds to go in the power play. Long shot wide of the goal. Might have had a chance to get that in a little closer. Once again cleared by BC. Mitani back to pick it up. D watching her. Mitani up to Fast through the middle. Emma Powell, and she's sent back. 15 seconds go in the power play. Power play's over. Back comes Smith. Smith down the right side. Couldn't get it to Yui. Just came out of the penalty box. Tuba gets her to clear to the boards against Zikowicz. Zikowicz goes down. They'll call a penalty. Brooke Tuba go to the penalty box. Another power play for the North Stars from Manitoba. Timeout, Manitoba. Thank you. BC win the faceoff, clear it down. It's a 5-on-3. 4-minute penalty going against Summeryou. He just came out of the penalty box. Now she's back in, and that'll be offside. Great chance here for Manitoba, but they haven't done much with their power play opportunities up until now. Kicked away by Graywall. Matani steps into it and hit a couple of players in front of the goal and goes to the boards. And come back to Matani. Again, it's 5-on-3 for another minute. That shot misses. Calhart has it, sends it down the floor. Graywall with another save as she dropped down the butterfly, got the pads on it. Smith can't get it past Matani. She's able to hold the line. Good work by Maggie Matani. Comes to the boards. Fast. Time winding down in the first penalty. Whistle goes. 9 seconds left to go in the 5-on-3. Then we'll have just over 2 minutes of 5-on-4. 7 minutes exactly to go in the second period. Still remains, well, sorry, it is 2-1. Remains 2-1. I tell you, it's getting late and I've got one more to go. This is going to be rough. You might want to stay locked in just to see how this works out. I think it'll be okay. 2-1 BC over Manitoba. Manitoba scored first, BC with two late in the first. Calhart again turns. Boy, she is strong on her stick. First penalty is over. We're down to 5-on-4 now for another minute 52 seconds. They get it in. Just kept it onside. Boy, Calhart again. So good on this penalty kill. She's got it again, turns. Put a star by her name just for this penalty kill. It's been sensational. More good work by BC. That was Lee. Kept it down in the Manitoba end. She's got it again. Just a minute to go in the power play. They can't get it from Lee. Michelle Lee. Finally they do. Good pass in. Scores! Oh, beautiful passing play. They threw it around. Hit it in over the blue line. Zikowitz. Watch this. One. And then the return pass. Just got to tap it in. Skyla Burns finishes it off. And we are tied at 2. Great penalty killing right up till the last few seconds. And then that one breakout by Manitoba, they take advantage. going to be another penalty call. BC's got is going to go against Manitoba. They touch it up. BC will go on the power play now. Holding. .455 to go, second period. We're all tied at two. Girls under 19 semifinal. BC win the faceoff. Cho. Molly Cho allowed to walk right in, shoots. Went into the corner. Shot on goal. Glass has got that. She'll hold on to it. Behind the goal. Fed it out in front. Nobody there at all for BC, so they've got to go back into their own end. Could have been offside. Back to get it. Fitzpatrick off the boards. Can't get it out. It's kept in. Now Manitoba has it and clears the zone all the way down the floor. Raywall leaves it there for her defense. Cal Hart to the red line, no further. Zahn in there looking for it as well for BC. Patano doing great work. Actually, that's number 10. Nekwajuk. In a way, only 30 seconds left to go in the power play for BC. Zahn, still not in. Bolima will chase it down in the corner. And down the floor it goes, and that's going to do it. Just 8 seconds left in the penalty. Turning, Kostinen. Got it up to Pogor. Penalty is over. Getting some more information about some possible schedule changes as a result of heat at the Robert French. Maybe moving some games from there to here tomorrow. We'll let you know as soon as we know. We do know that there is one game being played after this one. We're going to have the boys U17 Withrow Park Knights against the Newfoundland Labrador Selects. Scheduled for the Robert French. They're going to move it to here after this girls semifinal. Soroviak dumps it in. Cho trying to get to it. Knocked away from her. Time winding down here in the second period. It's cleared away from the front of the goal. Here comes Pagosa. Pagosa through the blue line looking for Zahn. Pagosa's on it again, shoots it in. Well, wide of the goal, going back to get it. Fitzpatrick played it off the boards. Not a great angle. Comes out in front. Belima with a shot. That just went wide. 40 seconds left. BC in there on the hunt. Fitzpatrick has to reverse it. Gets it behind the goal. Brown over into the corner to Fast. She'll clear it down the floor. That's going to be flooring, so there's going to be a faceoff back in the Manitoba, and 19.7 seconds left. Molina with a shot, scores! 3.3 seconds left. Can you see, get it in. I think they have it cleared away. Belima gets her stick on it and from the circle rips it. Top shelf. And the celebration's on for all the BC fans down to our right and on the floor. So a goal right at the end of the second period has BC out in front. 3-2 in this girls under 19 semifinal. The winner will play Newfoundland and Labrador Selects tomorrow for a national championship. 2 minute break, and we'll be back. BC lead the semifinal 3-2 on the strength of a goal with 3.3 seconds left to go in the second period. 15 minutes to go at least. Goes to the boards. Zahn in there for BC. Tremblay in, but coming away is Kiera Prosic. Prosic gets it down low. Back to pick it up. Mira Smith. And BC will get it out. Tremblay knocked away from her. Cleared by Carnegie. Pagosa, shot on goals. Couple of saves by Glass. That ball is still loose. They score, Pagosa. The ball was never covered. We could see it from here plainly. Here's the first shot. Glass made the save, but the rebound was there. There's the second one. And the ball is there, Pagosa. Gives BC a two-goal lead. She's a little excited. Around the boards, looking for it over there. That was Nekwichuk. Lazat couldn't get it out. Dumped back in by BC. Emma Powell behind her goal. Powell. To this side, Lazat. Lazat plays it down along the boards, going down there to get it. Penny, but she won't reach it in time. It'll be a flooring call against Manitoba. That rang off the crossbar. A shot from Hannah Kostinen over the glove of Glass and off the crossbar. BC in looking again. Belema gets it to the front of the goal. They whack away at it. It stays out. All BC now. We're all over Manitoba. Backhanded in again. Cho in there forechecking. Fitzpatrick plays it around the other side. DiStasio, she can't get it out. It's cleared, but still onside. Burns. Ball goes off the glass. Kept in by Soroviak. Soroviak along the boards, can't reach it. Manitoba will get it out. Off the boards, Burns, but much too hard. That's going to be another flooring call. Malaquette from the point, went off a leg. Oh, shot in by Kouche. Manitoba just owning the, oh, sorry, BC owning the ball right now. So, Soroviak along the boards. Zahn. Matani can't knock it down. Back in it goes, right in front. Oh, what a chance for Soroviak. Glass with another save. They steal it again. Another shot, another save by Glass. She'll hold on. She robs Zahn on that one. The goal by BC with 3 seconds left in the second has proven to be huge. They've ridden that momentum here into the third, and they have owned the third period. They've added a fourth goal. And they've had the ball down in the Manitoba end almost constantly. Polgor. Tremblay. Manitoba, get it, can't get it out. It goes to the boards. Coming in to help Lazat. Pergosa puts it back behind the goal. Fast is there. To Lazat. Long pass, knocked down at center, that's still onside. Shot, save made by Glass. Pagosa in behind the goal, taken away by Emma Powell. Emma Powell makes a move and heads up the floor. Pagosa trying to catch up to her. Powell. Lays it off on the left side to Nekwichuk. It'll be kept in. Now BC get it out. It'll go down the floor and it'll be a flooring call against Team BC. 9:15 left. Of players from the other BC teams here in the arena tonight. And Team BC is getting a lot of support. And off the goaltender. Graywall to the boards. Manitoba trying to get something going. They get to the back of the goal. Dickowitz is in to help out. It comes to the boards. BC on it first. BC still on it. We come to the center of the floor. Shot in by Zahn. Behind the goal, Seroviak. Seroviak trying to get it out in front. She'll go back again. Watch by Brown. Scores! She got it out in front. And Valaquette was there. Correction, 49. Zahn. Alicia Zahn with that goal for BC. That may have put it out of reach. Seroviak doing amazing work down behind the goal. Gets it out in front. Here's Zahn. No chance for Glass. 5-2. Comes to the side of the goal. Bounces into the goaltender and Graywall will cover it up. BC back behind their own goal, into the corner. Long shot in by Powell, knocked down just inside the blue line. Drew lost it. It's chipped out. Racing after it, Bolema got Pogar in front. Broken up, Bolema's got it again. Turn, shoots off a stick. Again, that was Alicia Powell, the block. Playing her heart out there. Pogar lost it. It's kept in by Bolema. Great work, Carnegie. Out at center. Kostinen. Kostinen breaks in, shoots over the top of the goal. Nekwichuk. Stopped as she got to the blue line. Back they come, Seroviak. She lost it. Up at center, stop, brought back in by BC. Kostinen. Along the boards, under 6 minutes to play. Zahn. Right in on goal, Glass made the save. It's gonna be a hooking call, I would think, against BC. Let's see. Yep. Manitoba on the power play. Last ditch effort. Matani. So it is a power play for Manitoba. Matani. Over on the left side, she'll get it back. Pass was in her feet, she'll get the ball to settle. And then mishandle it. Matani trying to keep it in after that bit of a mistake. She does. But BC come up with it. Now it'll go down the floor. Dickowitz. One minute to go in the power play. Dickowitz will bring it up the floor. She's going to be pressured, so she'll move it to the left side. He'll get it in over the blue line, but that is going to be offside. McConaughey slams her stick on the floor in frustration. Faceoff win for BC, and that will allow them to send it down the floor. Janelle D in on the forecheck. Gets there ahead of the Manitoba player. Comes free. Lizotte. Knocked off her stick again by Janelle D. To Lizotte. Back it goes, sent down this time by Michaela Cush. Lizotte back to Carnegie. Carnegie shoots it in. Tuba back there first. Over to Zahn. And that will get out. Penalty is now over. And time running out in this one. Just 3 minutes left to go. 3-goal lead. Knockdown, BC. I'll just flip it down into the Manitoba end. The clock is their friend. Penny can't get it in over the blue line. Pagosa. Palema. Working it off the boards. Palema backhand scores. Esther Bolema. She'll take the pass and she'll go get it off the boards. And she does a great job here beating the Manitoba player and shows a good backhand beating glass. 6-2, BC is headed to the national championship tomorrow. Where they will play the Newfoundland and Labrador selects. Timeout, Manitoba. The other BC girls team down below us is celebrating. Penalty coming up to Manitoba. They touch it up, 2:04 to go. Here we go. There's the other BC girls team celebrating. They're having a party. It's been going on for a while down below us. Great support. It's the under 16 team supporting the under 19 team. It is a power play for Manitoba. Academic, 1:48 left to go. BC definitely heading to a gold medal game. Manitoba still has another game to play. They'll have a chance to play for a bronze tomorrow against New Tecumseh. Put this one behind you and try and come back tomorrow with a good effort. They've got the net empty. Try and get themselves a goal here, at least on this power play. Shot down the floor, wide of the goal. Back to get it, Kiara Prosik. Dickiewicz. DC get it, send it down the floor. They'll go wide of the goal. 1:14 to go. Prosik in over the blue line. To Matani. Matani down in the corner into the final minute of this one. BC is on the power play, so that is a flooring call. And another one. On towards the empty net, that goes wide. Zahn, hold it against the boards, kill some time, whistle goes, 16.6 left. If you missed it earlier, we have some bonus coverage for you. Coming up next, boys under 17, Withrow Park Knights taking on the Newfoundland and Labrador Selects, a game that's scheduled to be played at the Robert French Arena. But because of high humidity and heat at the Robert French Arena, much smaller arena, they have moved the game here, so we are going to have an extra one. This game was scheduled to be over by about 9:30, 20 past. So we're going to have a late night, and we're enjoying it. I hope you are too. I know the girls from BC are enjoying it. They are having a party here at the CBS Arena. Final buzzer, celebration is on. BC will play for a national championship tomorrow evening against Newfoundland and Labrador Selects. Actually, it'll be tomorrow afternoon. The game is scheduled for 3 o'clock. In all fairness, don't count on it being at exactly 3 o'clock. These things always tend to run later than the schedule says. We'll get the player of the game presentations, and then we'll get set for our final game, boys under 17. And check the CanadaBallHockey.ca website for changes to the schedule tomorrow. If there are any, I'm hearing there may be some changes as games from the Robert French may get moved here. Not done yet, but it's certainly a possibility. Player of the game for Manitoba. That's number 4. Jared DiStasio. Alicia Zahn, player of the game for British Columbia. Okay, folks. This was supposed to be the end of the road for us today. I'm supposed to have ended about an hour ago. But we're going to keep going. Why not? I've still got half a muffin left. All right, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be back with that game between Withrow Park, Newfoundland and Labrador Selects in a few minutes, probably about 10 minutes from now by the time they shake hands. Teams get to warm up. Come back and join us.